In this tutorial, we will cover how to use BackTrack Linux to copy files from a corrupted Windows file system to an external drive or network location, even if the Windows system won't boot. This will also work to recover files from a corrupted Linux system. What is BackTrack Linux? BackTrack is a Linux distribution based on Ubuntu and focused on network analysis and penetration testing. BackTrack is booted and run in live mode, so no installation is required. BackTrack is great for recovering files from a Windows file system that won't boot. Basically, you boot to the BackTrack USB drive we will set up. You will then be able to open your hard drive files from FAT and NTFS disks and copy them to external media or to a network location like a Windows share. To boot to a USB drive, you need to enter your computer BIOS and change the boot order so that the USB drive comes before the hard drive. This way, when we turn on the computer, we'll start to the USB drive and not to the hard drive. This will be different for every computer, but basically right after the computer starts, when you see the text portion of startup, you click usually F1, F2, or Delete to enter the system BIOS. It will tell you this on screen when the computer is turned on. In the BIOS, you look for something referring to boot order, and then change the order so that the USB drive is the first boot device. The USB drive needs to be connected to the computer before you boot and try to change this. Let's start the computer. Make sure that you have the USB drive we created previously in the back of the computer you want to recover, and that the USB drive is set as the first boot device in the BIOS. To be able to record this process, I am going to be running a virtual machine of Windows XP using VirtualBox. I have two hard drives set up in this virtual machine. Each drive is 10 gigabytes. One drive is FAT32, and the other one is NTFS. Start the computer. On the BackTrack Live CD window, select BackTrack Text. On the Welcome to BackTrack screen, next to root at root, pound, type startx and press enter. When BackTrack finishes loading, you will get to the GNOME desktop. Let's review the disk drives that are attached to this system. Click on the Places menu, then Computer. The Computer File Browser window will open. Here, we have the drive and file system devices. File system. The file system device is the USB drive with the BackTrack files on it. Here we have the two 10 GB drives we created earlier. For some reason, they are showing as being 11 gigabytes instead of 10 gigabytes. I was not able to find any information as to why this is. On the NTFS device, we have the test file that was created earlier, as well as a hidden Windows system folder. On the FAT32 device, we can see all of our Windows files. In many cases, you will want to back up the Documents folder of any user on that system that won't boot. The Users folder from the Documents and Settings folders contain the user's Word, Excel, and other documents, the user's ntuser.dat registry file, as well as settings and desktop shortcuts. Let's open the Documents and Settings folder. The JAG Tutorials folder is our user folder, as this is the name I created for my user. Right-click on it and select Copy. We now need to copy this folder to either some form of removable media or to a network location. We will cover both options. Option 1. Copying to removable media. You could have another USB drive and copy it to that if you want, but we will just copy it to the USB drive we booted to. Click the Places menu, and then Computer. The device labeled File System is the USB drive we booted to. Double-click to open it. You can put the files anywhere you want to, but I would recommend placing them in the Home folder. Let's open Home. In the Home folder, right-click and select Paste. Once you have the files copied over, you can just put it in another computer to retrieve the information. Option 2. Copying to a network location, like a Windows folder share. NIM resolution doesn't always seem to work, so I always use the IP address of the share server. On the computer where I have the Windows share set up, I will click on the Windows Start button, and then select the Run item. In the Run window that opens, enter CMD and press Enter. Enter IPCONFIG, IPconfig, and then press Enter. We need to take note of the IPv4 address, which in this case is 192.163.0.3. Close the window. To access a Windows share, BackTrack uses Samba. Let's click on the Places menu, and then select Connect to Server. The Connect to Server window will open. Under Service Type, it lists various network connections you can make, such as a Windows Share, SSH, and FTP. We will select Windows Share. For this server, we need to enter the IP address we got earlier. I'll enter 192.168.0.3. Your address will most likely be different than mine. For share, enter the name of the Windows share. In this case, the share name is Downloads. We will skip folder, but we could enter a folder name within the share if we wanted to open that instead. In the username field, you need to enter the name of the Windows user from the server with access to the share. The username for the computer needs to be the IP address, / and then the username. In this case, the test username is Sasha. So I will enter 192.168.0.3/SACHA. In the domain field, enter the IP address again. And then click the Connect button. The password required for share window will open. Enter the password. And now you can set it to either remember the password forever or immediately forget. I'll just leave it as the default and click Connect. A file browser window will open displaying the contents of your share. Let's create a new folder. We'll name it Test Folder. Open the folder, and then once inside, right-click and select Paste. And there you have it. We've both copied the files to the USB drive and off to a network share. There's a ton of great tools included in BackTrack Linux. We will only cover copying files in this tutorial. I hope this helps recover data from corrupted systems for you. I know it's been a huge help for me in the past.